Clinical trials are really important because we need to use them to try and improve the way we understand disease, how we better use therapies that we already have, and how we then position new therapies, which are really good opportunities to try and tackle disease. Clinical research is a really important part of being a doctor, because it's only through clinical research that you can then start to understand the disease and then make changes that will then improve the care of your patients. So I'm a clinical trials investigator and I find it a really privileged position. So when I was first interviewed in medical school, I said that what I wanted to do was to make a difference for patients, and that's never left me. So what I can actually do through research is then identify where the challenges are and then meet them head on by then undertaking research. And the kind of research I've done and other investigators do means that you actually can take discoveries right through to new therapies and change the lives of your patients. I'm a clinical investigator on a number of different trials, and my role is there to be an important player in terms of then the development of the protocol, so the idea behind the study, and then the oversight all the way through from then recruiting patients into the study, ensuring safety throughout the study, and then the interpretation of the data that then comes from the trial at the end, and then the more broader dissemination, meaning then talking to patients and the wider community about the outcome from the trial. Before enrolling into a clinical trial, patients need to consider whether they wish to be in the study, whether it has value to them, and also then the impact that trial might have in terms of the time commitment and the tests that are done. I think it's always important that they consider really how this might benefit them and how it may also be valuable to patients in general. Depending on the type of study patients are involved in, then they might see the same investigator for each of their visits, and their visits may be quite short and really be restricted to questions. And in other studies where we're then looking at new therapies, there may be a very large team, which might include the nurse team taking assessments through to technologists and basic scientists that are looking at very specific questions that are related to the trial. It's really important that the people become engaged in clinical trials, and one way of doing this is actually making sure that the clinical trials and the research are very closely integrated with clinical care. And certainly in some hospitals, such as the one I work in, we very much encourage every patient that's coming into clinic or acutely to then participate in research, and it becomes an expectation. And I think this is something that's really important, that people then realise that it's actually part of improving their care. One of the things that people have considered in the past is that the patient's role in trials is very much as a participant only. And I think one of the things that's really evolved over the last few years especially is then the building of partnerships with patients. So what do I mean by that? Well, what I mean is that then patients are involved in the research questions. They're then involved in the development of the protocols. They're involved in then the wording of patient information sheets and better ways to then engage with patients. Before a trial is set up, then there's a very close involvement between the potential study participants and the trial team. Clearly there needs to be very, very clear explanations through the patient information sheet and then gaining consent. And at that time, there's really a very good opportunity for the patients to then ask all of the questions that they have. But then throughout the study, at any point where they have any misunderstanding of the trial, it's really important that you have an environment in which they can ask any questions they want. There are different ways that patients then come into research trials. Some of those patients are already seeing clinicians that are involved in research. Sometimes their clinician will suggest that they consider a research trial and then refer them to a clinician that's specialising in that area. But sometimes you simply don't know your way in. You don't know how to then be engaged in research. And to do that, then you can then access information through major charities in the UK. That's a good example of that would be Asthma UK.